crew welcomes to one and all. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuhu. Now in this episode we will see that how Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam got married to Khadija radhiyallahu ta'ala anha. So how did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam meet Khadija? How did this come about? Now it so happened that Khadija's older sister had a flock. She had a herd of camels, and her older sister hired the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to take their flock out and to graze them outside of Makkah. And she hired two people. We didn't know how their names, other two persons, the Prophet and another young man. After the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam finished, so they had to go back into the town in order to collect the wages. So the young man that was with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and at the age of the Prophet, he said that you also come with me, but now that we are done, come, let's go and ask our wages from Khadija's sister. So the Prophet said, why don't you go on my behalf, because I'm too shy to go, because she is a woman. So the person came to Khadija's sister, and it so happened that Khadija was in her own house at the time, and he asked for the wages. Khadija said, where is Muhammad? He also has one half of the wage. Where is Muhammad? So the man said he was too shy to come and ask it from you. So at this, Khadija's older sister said that I have not seen any man who is more shy and more noble and more honorable and more chaste in his interactions and in his behavior and in his nature. Because she is interacting with him, because she is a woman, so she knows he is lowering his gaze, he is acting in a very elegant manner. And so she says, I have never seen any man more, and she kept it praising for. And the narrator to this report says, this was the first time Khadija heard of his name. And just like any human being, that when a person is praised in such a manner, something entered in her heart, because he is being praised in such a noble manner. And eventually later on in the year, Khadija had to send her own caravan to Syria, and Khadija owned a lot of wealth because she is a woman, she cannot go herself to do it. So every single time she has to hire a businessman, a tycoon, a man to do her work. And when she heard the praise about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, she decided, why don't I choose this young man? And so she sent a message to the Prophet, why don't you take this caravan? So Prophet went to Abu Talib and said, oh my uncle, Khadija has sent me such and such offer, what do you think? And so Abu Talib basically said that, oh my nephew, Khadija is well known to be the richest woman of the city, and you know this is the definitely much better than the job you are doing now. You are going to get a good sustenance. Allah has blessed you with this opportunity. Do not say no to her. And Khadija sent one of her servant along as well with him, and the Prophet took the caravan to the city of Basra. So Khadija had sent her servant, the name is given as Masariya generally. So when the Prophet went to Basra and then returned, when the Prophet came back to Maisara, told Khadija of the care and the concern of the Prophet, and the Prophet made double or triple, the Arabic says, which means they miss many time more the Prophet than anybody else had made before him. This is now increasing the emotions that Khadija has, and there is nothing wrong at all with her now having a desire to marry the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And what lady would not have desired to marry the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? The details differ about but they all agree about one thing: Khadija was the one who instigated, started it. In one version, Khadija told the friend, or it says another servant of hers who was elderly woman, Nafisa, and she expressed an interest in marrying the Prophet. So Nafisa said, leave this to me, I will arrange it. And so she visited the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and she was an elderly lady, and she said, oh Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, again he is not a prophet at this time, oh Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, why don't you get married? So the Prophet smiled and said, who would marry me, because I am an orphan, poor person of the Quraysh. So basically, I'm an orphan and I'm poor, who is going to marry me? So Nafisa said, what if Khadija wanted to marry you? What if Khadija, so she's not saying Khadija is sending me, but it is there, what if
My master, what if my friend Khadija wanted to marry you? And the Prophet was quiet, and then he said, why would she want me? Notice, he didn't say I'm not interested in her. Okay, he's wondering why would she want me. So the message is given that is that he is interested, because he didn't say no, I'm not interested in her. Rather, he's thinking, why would she want somebody like me? Because I'm such an orphan and not somebody that was worthwhile. But he is Rasulullah, and he was going to be Rasulullah. And so Nafisa went back and told Khadija that there is a matter such and such. Ibn Ishaq says, by the way, that the marriage took place in the month of Safa, 3 months after the return from Basra, 3 months after the journey. So Ibn Hajar and others point out that Khadija's father had died, that her uncle Amr ibn Asad became her, and Abu Talib came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Abu Talib performed all the customs, and the sermons is recorded in one of the early books that Abu Talib began by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then taking about the lineage further, and that we are the noble descendants of Ibrahim and Ismail, that Allah has blessed us with this and this, and that of the blessings we are how is that, and Allah has blessed to be the people of Makkah, and my nephew the Prophet Muhammad, my nephew is the one who is no comparison with any other young man in all of Makkah, in his manners and in his behavior and in his nobility and in his lineage, and he has proposed to your noble lady, your noble daughter, your noble lady Khadija, with a dowry of 12 is a nugget of silver, and so 12 nuggets of silver with a little bit of some coins of silvers as well. And so he gave Amr, Khadija's uncle, stood up and said, this is the young man who cannot be refused. We accept the proposal. So the blessings of Khadija are simply to notice. And she was the first to believe in the Prophet. She comforted him as soon as the revelation began. She was the one who thought, let's take him to the and ask what is happening. And she was the only one whom Jibreel would come into household of Khadija, and he would not enter any other household. Aisha, Umm Salama, and no one, he only entered the house of Khadija, and Jibreel told the Prophet, once when the Prophet was sitting in the Makkah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to the Khadija that, Khadija, here is Jibreel, because Jibreel would enter and Khadija was in the house, the only wife you would enter, here is Jibreel, and he is sending Allah's salam upon you, he is sending the Allah's salam upon you, and he is going, he is giving you that glad tidings of the house in Jannah, where there is not going to be any noise and any struggling. You will have peace in that household. So Khadija responded that Allah is as-salam, and may salam be upon Jibreel, and may salam upon you. This was Khadija's response. And we had already said that Khadija had been married twice before as well. So the children, they were from her first marriage. She had a son named Hala. Hala accepted Islam eventually, and he lived a noble life with the Prophet Muhammad. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Khadija had at least 6 children together in their period of marriage. I already said that all of the children of the Prophet were through Khadija, and the first child of the Prophet, you should all know his name, it is Qasim. It is said that Al-Qasim had reached to the age the boys could ride on the camel, 6, 7, 8 years old maybe, and then he passed away. And then the Prophet had Zainab, Ruqayya, Umm Kulsum, Fatima, the youngest daughter, 4 daughters. So then he had his final son with Khadija, that is Abdullah. And Abdullah died in infancy without even in Islam. He was born after that, and he died in Islam. Of course, the 4 daughters, all of them lived to maturity, and the only one daughter lived, 3 of them died in his own life. So he buried his own daughters with his hands. The 3 daughters he buried with his hands. And now Ibrahim, by the way, was not
born of his wife, it was born of his maidservant. His none of the other wives of the Prophet became pregnant other than Khadija. So this is what all about the very noble, respected, blessed and pure relationship and the married life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam with Khadija radhiyallahu ta'ala anha. In next episode we will see that Prophet Muhammad's and the case or the story of the black stone. So till that time, please like, share and subscribe our channel Combo Pro. Thank you very much.